Hi, it's Fran with Little Windows. Today I'll show you how to make a bangle bracelet with a window. You can put anything you like into your window. I'm creating this effect with the new mold dividers from littlewindows.com. These dividers are made to be used with the bangle bracelet side of our double-sided molds. Each pack comes with a guide showing some of the amazing things you can create, including cuff bracelets, color blocks like the window we'll make today, and teardrop castings you can make using the handle part. I'll be using the oval-shaped double-sided mold and Brilliant Resin. Each set includes four dividers made of a soft, flexible silicone, perfectly shaped to fit into these molds. If you wanted to make a cuff bracelet, you'd want the gap between dividers to match your wrist size. But for this project, I can make my window any size I want. I first made this one with tiny cows. I'm going to be making a similar bangle, so I'll space my dividers about 2 to 2.5 inches apart. Pull open the side of your mold and push the divider down against the bottom, making sure it's standing up straight. Then place your second divider. The goal is to prevent or at least minimize any leakage around the dividers. So stretch the rubber band that comes in this set around the top of the mold to hold the edge against your dividers until your resin has set up. I'm ready to mix resin. The oval bangle mold takes about 30 milliliters to fill. I'll need less than that because of the window. I'm using these super clear EasyBatch measuring cups. All the markings are easy to read. On one side, milliliters are clearly marked on the outside of the cup, so they won't disappear as you fill them with liquid. The markings on the other side of the cup are made for resins with a 2-to-1 mix ratio, like my Brilliant Resin. This side has three batch sizes marked, 9 milliliters, 15 milliliters, and 24 milliliters. All you have to do is pour part A up to the A line, then add part B up to the B line, and you'll have a perfect ratio. Easy. If your part A gets cold, it can thicken and hold on to bubbles. You can see this is flowing pretty slowly, so once I measure, I'm going to warm up my resin following the directions on the label. Now it's nice and thin, and it'll blend very easily with my part B. Blend for 2.5 minutes. These cups are super smooth on the inside, so use your mixing wand to wipe around the bottom edge and sides and make sure your mix is well blended. Then let your mix rest in the cup for 5 minutes so it can blend more thoroughly and any bubbles can rise and pop. For this project, I'm adding black colorant, but you can use any color you want. Shake well and add just a few drops to the resin. See how easily this colorant blends in, making a glossy, opaque black. Open the edge so it's easier to fill the mold. Let the resin flow and level out, and then fill it to the top. You want to fill just below the marker on the divider. Be sure your surface is level before pouring resin. I'm using a creation station to protect my projects while they set up, and after my resin has thickened a bit, I can move this creation station if I need to make more space. I'm not wearing gloves in this video. Brilliant Resin is the safest epoxy you'll find, and I'm working in small, manageable batches, but I always make sure that my space is well ventilated. If you have chemical sensitivities, if you're mixing larger batches, making larger projects, or using resin frequently, make sure to protect yourself with an organic vapor mask or respirator and gloves. It's been 12 hours and my black resin has set up, so I can remove the band. See here, a bit of resin leaked around the divider, but that's okay. Usually it'll come out when you remove the divider, and any extra can be easily removed or trimmed. Like I did in my cow bangle, I'm going to pour my window in layers. So first I'll place the band around the bottom. I'll be embedding this little rubbery shark, and I want it to look like he's swimming in the ocean, so I'll do a thin layer of sand at the bottom. I mix a tiny batch of resin, and I'll mix the sand into that. If I pour dry sand into my mold, it'll be messy and there'll be bubbles. I'll scoop this in and use a tiny pointy swab to remove any sandy bits from the edges of the mold and push the sand around where I want it to be. When I'm done using them, I like to wrap my blue band around my dividers box to keep them together. I let the extra black resin cure in my cup, and now I can remove it and reuse this cup over and over. Because these cups are completely smooth and polished on the inside, the resin should come out easily, and if you blend it well, it shouldn't be sticky. I use these pieces in a variety of projects so nothing goes to waste. Now just pick the bits off of the cup and give it a wipe with alcohol and it'll be ready to use again. Let your first layer set up for 3 hours before pouring the next layer. Now I'll mix up a small batch to fill my little window. I want to tint this slightly to make it look like water, so I'll add 2 drops of alcohol ink. I'm also going to add a little bit of sparkle. Now fill your little window about 2/3 of the way, leaving space to insert the shark. This mold will allow objects up to about 4 millimeters wide. If your object is wider, you can try cutting it in half before inserting it. I'm using tweezers to get it in the right position, then fill your mold to the top. Cover it up for about 10 minutes and check for bubbles. Then let your casting set up for a full 12 hours. I like how this looks. I got a few bubbles trapped under his belly, but it kind of looks natural. And I like how the glitter just sparkles ever so slightly. Remove your mold. You'll see there's a dip all around the top edge that comes from underfilling the molds. That's easy to fix by doming up the edge. I'll use my EasyBatch cup to mix a tiny batch of resin. Let that mix set in the cup for 5 to 10 minutes, and then carefully apply with your mixing wand. You can place your bangles on a doming tray. I didn't need one because I'm working with the creation station, and if any resin overflowed, it could easily be removed from the base. I let that domed portion thicken up a little bit, and I've decided to mix a little white colorant into a puddle of resin and use a straight pin to create some ocean-looking waves and froth just on the top portion. Let the resin finish setting and they're ready to wear. I just love how these turned out. What will you put in your little window? I'd love it if you subscribed, click the bell, and you'll know when I have a new video.